Now, your question was about how, what would we, what was your question?
The question was, there was a millage passed to put more police officers on the street. How would you propose ensuring that public safety millage funds are spent solely on public safety, on putting more police officers on the street?
As a city council person coming in on the November the 5th election, we still will be coming in under a emergency manager. But my goal is that I have put together some research material to bring forth to the emergency manager that we, the citizen of Flint, went to the poll and we asked and we voted in approval of this millage. And we have not gotten what we have voted for. In my research, it's more than just about giving me 10 police officers. Then we need to also supply the technology with these officers so they can combat crime. We need more updated technology like Crime Light, where you can walk in on a scene, right the Crime Light, you can pick up the body fluid, you can pick up the fiber right there on the spot. They got other technologies out there that our police officer is desperate need of. They got one called the Thermal, and the Thermal can pick up a fleeing criminal within minutes, not seconds. It's also good for, even if a child is missing, whether spending 2 and 3 hours looking for that child, you can get that child within minutes. So as a city council person, I am concerned about police officers, but why would you give them something that they can't compete with these criminals out here? The criminal technology is up here, and we're living in outdated technology to support our police department. So as we once go again and say, yes, I am probably more upset than anybody in here. We all are upset because we're still having the same problem, and the criminal is getting all the technology. They have outwitted the police department. By the time they come on the scene, they're gone. But if we have the right technology, we can pick them up instantly and then continue to use those databases that's out there. But it's gonna require technology plus more police officers.
Your time is up.
Okay, Mrs. Weaver, one more time, the question.
Sure. There was a millage passed to put increased police officers on the street. How would you propose ensuring that public safety millage funds are spent solely on public safety, solely on increasing the number of police on the streets?
Yes, when the millage was passed, we were told we would have a number of officers, and it sounded like it would happen immediately. But then when we did get the money, it's like, now we have a different story. We're getting piecemeal of the officers that we should have, and it's not being effective. And it takes so long for them to go through training. So by the time we get a couple of them trained, that's months down the road, and then pretty soon we have to go through the same process again. I think that when you have other departments, like the state police coming in and helping out, that's fine. But we need to also have Flint police officers involved and working together as a team so we can increase our enforcement in the area. I don't know if there is a way that we can get better information on how this money is being spent. I've heard talk about maybe having some type of audit done, but there needs to be a flow of communication, a flow of data. What monies we have, where is it going, how is it going to help the police department, and even maybe we need some type of civilian police commission that will be involved in looking at what is going in our department.
Yes, I think the way that we can make sure that the money is being spent is when we get somebody in line who can micromanage the affairs and dealing with the $5.3 million. But most importantly, I just want to elaborate on this. When we're dealing with public safety, we need to also make sure that we deal with the mindsets of the people that's committing the crimes out there in our society. Most people that's out here committing crimes in our society has lost the hope of life. So when they lose the hope of life, and they've always been told that they will never account to anything, they begin to allow that to become their reality, and that's how they act. They act by what people perceive them to be. And most of the time, most of our problems occur based on what people expect of us. You have kids out here shooting guns in the air. Everybody in the neighborhood telling him he's a killer. He's beginning to believe that. He has a confrontation in front of a store somewhere. He has to do exactly what people expect him to do. We need somebody intact, and this is the reason why I'm going for city councilman, because I am a hope and inspiration to a lot of men in my community who has lost that hope, who sees that they can become something better than what they are. They love for a person to come up to them who's not empathetic, but sympathetic. Empathy is, I can imagine what you're going through. Sympathy is, I know exactly what you're going through, and I can give them a great idea of where they can go. This is what the people need in society, especially in the urban community. You can't come out there telling them to do anything else if you don't have sympathy. You need to be a great example and a role model to them. This is the only thing they need. They need somebody who can understand their plight, understand their deprivation, understand what's provoking them to do the things that they're doing in society. And I'm telling you, I done had 3 or 4 men go put up guns. Go put them up. Ride with me in my car and never picked it up again. This is what they need. This is a strong public safety right here. We can be a public safety ourselves, but the $5.3 million need to be spent correctly. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I want to first off say that when the discussions and the campaign for the public safety millage was being campaigned to be voted on by the people, you the people, and it was approved, I took a position using my position as a city councilman to educate the community on reasons not to support that public safety millage for more police officers at the time, because there was not a strategic plan that was presented to the council that ensured that the money would be spent for 10 more police officers as it was presented to the people. So I knew it was not something that was being presented as the truth. And you know, this may go against popular belief, but really, we have more police officers on the street now with state police, and I don't believe more police officers on the street right now in the city of Flint is the answer to our issues of crime. We need more community policing. We need the community to be more involved with community policing. I was fortunate enough to travel with some other leaders from this community to go to San Francisco to a ceasefire conference back in 2009. And we brought back and introduced to the mayor and the chief of police the Flint Lifeline ceasefire initiative that is being implemented now. Currently, we are, in the first 6 months of this year, we are 25% less in violent crimes than we have been in the past. So there's progress that's being made, even though it's small. And in every major city that this lifeline has been presented, it has proven to reduce crime.
Your time is up.
2 minutes is up.
Sorry. But we're going to stay in the area of public safety, because I would think that once we have police on the street, the jail becomes an important part of the public safety equation. So the city lockup is funded by a grant. Once that grant expires, if the city lockup is to continue, how would you recommend it be paid for? And we'll start with Mr. Harris.
I'm sorry, I was... What, could you repeat the last aspect of the question?
If the city lockup is to continue, how would you recommend it be paid for?
Well, as most of you know, I believe the city lockup is been provided through state taxpayer funds. Mr. Waller mentioned state police input in our community. That's true. There's approximately 24 to 26 state troopers that have been provided. Where I'll disagree with the councilman, with all due respect, I do believe it is essential to reducing crime that we have the proper manpower, the proper amount of police and firefighters to provide the quality of life, the essentials to a community. If a community can't, a city can't protect its citizens, it's a city in deep trouble. It's essential that we have more police officers because you, the people, ask for more police officers. The state can pull out at any point. The governor can say, hey, he has a budget constraints or whatever. We need those state troopers elsewhere. We need to provide for our own. And I say to you, and I say to everyone I've spoken to, that public safety and the improvement of our quality of life is essential for this community going forward. I'm the only candidate, and I've said this door to door so many times, it's the mantra. I'm the only candidate that the Flint police officers and the Flint firefighters union endorsed through that primary. There's a reason for that. I've been fighting these issues for 20 odd years. I've been at the forefront of advocating for reform in this city government. Some others, with all due respect, they just came to the table in the last few months. That's not me. I'm gonna be the one that's out front fighting for you folks.